I just freed up a whole lot of space by piling books behind my couch, but I figure a shelf for back here would be much better. I've got some pieces from an old dresser and a couple of IKEA shelves, and that should be most of the material for the shelves I'm going to build. Two of my boards were a little bit too narrow, so I'm going to try to glue some pieces on there exactly flush, and hopefully I can keep that finished surface. The two boards are exactly the same thickness, so by putting a clamp right across the joint, I'm forcing the edges to be exactly flush with each other. So I got four short pieces and four long pieces to make two boxes, and I'll use my screw advanced box joint jig, of course. So I've got two of these boxes I still need to glue together, but before I do that, I want to figure out how to get a shelf in the middle here. And I want to join that in with fingers every 3/4 inch, which I'll once again cut with a box joint jig. To help me cut this, I made this scale with marks every 3/4 inch where I'm not supposed to cut. And these are just hand-drawn because the accuracy actually comes from the gear and stopping at certain increments. And this scale is just to make sure I don't lose count of my turns. I now have a series of tenons, and they're supposed to fit in a series of mortises like this, except I still need to round the corners here for them to actually fit. I'm going to cut this series of mortises using my slot mortising machine with a 1/4 inch bit, and I've got enough vertical range of travel that I can cut the whole series of mortises across the wide board. And to space them by 3/4 inch, I need to turn this 16 teeth per inch threaded rod 12 times for each increment, and to help me count the turns, I've got this wheel on here, so every time I turn this increments by one. I have 32 increments on this wheel, so after turning this by 24, once I turn it by another 12, it won't end up at 12, but it'll end up at 4, which is basically 12 times 3 minus 32. But it'll still help keep me getting off by 1. Thank you. tight. I chamfered the edge a bit first so that I don't chip out the wood as I exit on the chisel on the far end there. The finish is a little bit harder than the wood, so it's totally possible to scrape off the end grain without actually damaging the finish in between. I put 3 coats of varnish on them and also 1 coat on the surfaces that were already finished, and now they're ready. And they're nice and solid. Try that with something made with pocket holes. So the idea is I can put these shelves on top of each other to use as a conventional bookcase, but in this application I'm going to be putting them side by side. Out of sight, out of mind.